Hello everyone, so we just had to refilm the intro twice because there was a plane that was really, really loud, so you couldn't even hear us. Jarvis!
Today we're going to be filming a show prep, so we're going to Pycombe tomorrow, which will be Wednesday, and then we're staying till the Monday because it's like a 5-day show, but because it's so far away, it's 4 hours away, we're going to travel down the day before just to make sure that the horses are all settled in and that they don't have to compete on the same day that we travel down, because obviously they'll probably be really tired.
Yeah, so we're just going to obviously film us packing the lorry, what we take, why we're going to take it, and like
doing the horses, like cutting their manes and tails and...
Yeah, so it should be. People quite like packing dogs and stuff. I know a lot of people have messaged up there and saying, I know a lot of people have messaged and said, can you do like a packing stay away show kind of vlog? And obviously, we will vlog the whole show as well. Jarvis is just being an absolute boring look.
Jarvis!
He looks even funnier than this anyway.
Oh, she's a bit lower her nose. Do not. She was put out this morning, or my mum put her out, and she didn't have a rug on, and it was really wet. And then it was really windy, so we brought them in, and she was shivering a bit, bless her. But we took her on a hack along with Blaze and Leah, and she got back. And I've just put the equilibrium massage pad on her, and I'm just gonna turn her out in a second.
Lettuce. Kiss. Kiss.
You haven't got food. Oh, Lini.
Jarvis has this rug on just because it was raining earlier and he's clipped and he was a little bit shivery in the field, so we brought him in. But he needed to be brought in anyway so that we can do his mane and forelock and tail and just get him generally spruced up. Jarvis, look at the camera, thank you. So we're just packing the lorry now. Mum's already put the shavings in, but I think we might put a couple more in. I'm not too sure yet. But this morning we were actually very kindly given a bale of haylage from TH Scott and Sons. So I just want to say a massive thank you to them. The horses will well and truly be spoiled this week.
So, I need to put that in the rubbish bin. Some rubbish there. And just like clean some stuff up in here before we can start packing it. What's in here? Oh, I need to clean the fridge.
There's no light. First things first, while I'm taking the lorry keys, I'm wondering if I need them. I'll just stick in the door. I'm going to sort out Jarvis's food for the stay away. So we'll be bringing all of our supplements that we use, and including the ProPower Plus, because if Jarvis is doing 2 classes a day, that's 10 classes over the 5 days. So he'll probably need some more energy towards the end, and ProPower Plus is literally the perfect thing for that. I'm not too sure what I'm going to put it in. Yeah, but I guess I'll just figure that out in a minute. God, I literally, in this tap room, there's no like good perfect ways to like do time lapses or anything. So for Jarvis's slow release energy cues, I'm actually just going to put it back into the bag because they are actually in the tub thing. But I'm not going to need the whole tub, and we probably don't have room for the whole tub. So I'm just going to put how much he needs back in there, and then I'll probably get a carrier bag. And then put the trough on top of that, just so all of his food's gonna be in here. And now for the trough, his happy with trough. I'm just gonna stick it in this paper bucket because it won't tip over. We've used that for Dora's food before, and now I can just put it on the top of the bag and then. So. This is the aftermath of all the feed. So he's got his chaff in this bucket. Can't even see it. And then he's got his slow release energy cubes. And then we will be taking the equilibrium Vitamunches to keep them occupied in their stable. The cool ice for after they've competed, just to refresh their tendon. Then we'll also be taking the equilibrium electrolytes. We've got a whole pack of them. And then the more muscle pellets, the pro gut balancer, the immune, turmeric. Turmeric. Oh my god, I'm literally starting to say it like Molly. Glucosamine, I'll probably take 2 of these because this one's almost run out. And then the apple lights as well as the ProPower Plus. I don't know what the hose adjustment's doing there, but yeah.
Uh,
So I'm just going to be going to get Luna's stuff food ready. She's going to be given a breakfast and dinner just because she was obviously she's going to be competing quite a lot.
Bag was kind of empty, so I've just taken out that Happy Hoof and I'm going to put it in the Happy Hoof other bag that we have. So I'm making potions or something. And then I'm just going to put all of her chaff in that bag, just to make it convenient.
One.
Okay, so in there it's just all of her alfalfa profiber. I can't speak. For the stay away show. It's like 2 days worth in here, then I'm just gonna put the rest in there. That is really heavy. Oh, well that flopped. I did an extra cup anyway. So basically, 5 days worth of nuts. That is heavy.
So we always keep buckets in here for when we stay away. So we've got two water buckets in there, a purple bucket to fill up, stirry stick, a scoop, and then how many there? 4 feeding bowls. So for breakfast and lunch, breakfast and dinner. And then we've got our cook wheelbarrow. That's not actually the reg for our new lorry, that's for the old one. Some handy step ladders, and then at the back there, that's something that you put water in, then you like roll it across the floor so it's like easier. Yeah, and then we've actually taken out, oh look, we've got our drapes over there. And we've actually taken out our broom and our forks, but they'll be going in here as well. So I'm just gonna put Gus's food in here now. So yeah, right, little change of plan. I've just got the wheelbarrow out so that I didn't have to make so many trips with these. So I'm gonna load the wheelbarrow up with these and then go over there and put them over into the underfloor storage. We might not actually end up putting this in the underfloor storage. Oh my God, there's a spider. Oh my God, I hate them. Because the haylage bale is actually so big, so you might have to cut it in half and then put one in one side and then one in the other. But there'll still be obviously room for all of this and everything else, but this just might need to go in the back with the horses. But that'll be fine. Okay, now that is one full barrel of stuff. The annoying thing about this is, jeez, oh no, we've lost some gel. The annoying thing about this wheelbarrow is it's only on one thingy, one wheel. Oh no, we've got a spillage. Oh dear. You right there? Okay. Oh, geez. Why is that so bad? Okay, the quality is really bad for some reason, but I've got my bridle in here. Molly's got hers in, and then I've got my saddle, VIP pad, girth, fluffy, and my girth there. And then a pair of equilibrium open front tendon boots, front and back there. Molly's VIP pad there. I've just cleaned out all of this, first aid kit and tail bandages and some whips there, but I'm just gonna go do something with this. And then go get all of my numbness from down there, but I don't know why you can't see down there. But yeah. So I'm in the laundry room now. And is that done?
Yeah, okay.
So HD equine, whoa, I need to straighten these out. But my HD equine numbness in here, as well as my lovely Bella Rose one. It's all, isn't it? Yeah. No, I just need to find my spillers one that Mum's washed and then get the equilibrium one and then we're done. So I've got my EMDC one and then, hang on, whilst I unfold it, equilibrium and then my HD equine one and then my Bella Rose one, and then I've got my spillers one in the bag that it came in. So yeah, I would fit them all in the bag, but it wouldn't do up and I don't want to break the zip. So yeah.
So the saddle pads I'm taking are the equilibrium one. You can kind of see the logo down there. This just plain white one that's in Molly Cook in it, which is by Rug Up Now, because I know some people have been asking where these ones are from, because you can customize them and make them what you like. And then just the spillers and my other Molly Cook one, which is Snavy. So we're going to be bringing in the Equilibrium Therapy Massage Pad, and along with that, we're also bringing the Stable Chaps, Magnetic Stable Chaps, and then the Hind and Hock Magnetic Chaps as well, because obviously it's Stay Away shows. You don't have turnout, so it just keeps their legs nice and circulated and stops their legs getting stiff, obviously because of long periods of time spent in the stables. So I'm just going to see if I can put these in here, make a lot of space elsewhere. Oh, and I've taken out the charger, and it comes with a charger. You just plug it in, obviously, and charge it up. It's never got to the point where it's run out and I've had to go and charge it. But I just thought, you know what? I'll just charge up anyway and make sure it's got a full charge, because we might be using it quite a lot at the show. I haven't vlogged this yet, but just to let you know the things we've added. We've added the massage pad, another boots for, some more boots for the evening. This quick gloss hair spray, because, you know, we're always in a rush. Coat shine, the two VIP pads I've just put there. I've added my tack, added another bridle just in case, because last year I went to, one of Ella broke my bridle. So it's always good to have a spare. We've also just got the Navy Lemur Fly veil, ear bonnet, whatever you want to call it, just because Jarvis, as you know, is quite spooky. I'm just gonna put a fleece in the lorry for Luna in case it's a bit chilly. Day that we leave. Oh, that smells so good.
Honey nuts.
We managed to fit, is that half a bale?
Yeah, that's only half the bale of haylage. And the other half's on the inside because it's just massive. So it should last them the whole show, but if they're greedy pigs, then we might not.
We need to add in two shaving forks to make that way. Oh, where are they gone? He's just sitting in the school looking. Why do you look like a hunchback?
Come
here. Weirdo.
Come here,
boy. Oh, I'm going to miss you. Winnie, miss you. So the other Hayley's just here. We have got shavings.
Four barrels of shavings, wood pellets, which are really good if the temporary staples are going to be wet, if we do.
So we put that down first and the shavings on top, because sometimes they're like on dirt, it's grim.
If it rains, then all the rain will come in and get it all wet.
Yeah, and then...
yeah, that's really good. And then we've got two shaving forks, because me and Molly always argue over who cuts out first.
Yeah.
And then... Mum's got a massive juicer's bag over there.
Of?
Full of hay, so we're going to put that in the back.
Okay, so we're just gonna bring extra hay and stuff. We need to do nets. I think there's already nets done for them.
Basically, those machines are there because they're digging up the concrete in the yard.
Yeah, today. So we've had some issues with some of the water sitting sitting in the middle of the stables. So we are digging
not
it all
in the
up.
Middle of stables.
Yeah.
In the courtyard.
Like there, the water sits. Mm. So we've had to lock all the doors.
They're digging it all up and then they're moving the drain down so that it drains all into it.
Hello. So okay, we've got two hay nets for the journey. I think half of it's haylage, and half of it, I think it's at the bottom is.
No.
Mum said she put haylage in it.
Oh, spoiled.
Yeah, so half of it's haylage, half of it's hay. Bruno, stop eating the hay. Bruno, you're not a horse. Stop it. Bruno. Bruno, get off. It's the... no, don't encourage him to bite the hay net, please, Ella. Bruno, stop it. So we're just going to put these by the back of the lorry for when they go on.
Well, we're going
to
need to move forward.
Yeah. Bruno, stop pulling out hay. I'm going to go get Luna in a second. Loki! Look at little Loki. I gave her a bath the other day. Hello, puppy.
Bruno!
No one wants you. I'm joking. I'm gonna go get Luna because I need to do her mane. Like an hour or so out, just so she can obviously stretch her legs before we travel. Luna! Oh, okay, she's taking one look at me and wants to decide that she doesn't want to go. So Luna's in, I'm gonna quickly give her mane a tiny little trim, and I'm gonna put it in those little bunchy things that look cute, because the top of her mane keeps on going. Hold on. Top of her mane keeps on going like that. It's just really annoying me. So to make it a little bit flatter. What? But yeah, she's not very happy about being in. Why does it look so ugly? No, no. So I've just cut Jarvis's mane. Why are you looking at me like that? He's literally looking at me with the corner of his eyes. I've just cut his mane. I think it looked pretty good. It's a bit kinked where obviously Ella's had it in those flat things, but I think that's pretty good.
Okay, yeah, that's good.
And it's a lot shorter than what Ella wanted. I mean, no, it's a lot shorter than what it was, sorry.
Normally it looked like that,
so
yeah, that's good.
So yeah, Jarvis's all done. This is the process of doing Luna's mane. As you can tell, it sticks up a bit, but I'm gonna obviously put them through, but yeah. So Luna was all really clean, and then obviously she went out this morning and got herself very, very dirty. And I can't really rewash her mane because it will make it really hard. So it does look more yellow in this lighting, I promise. It is more grey, but she's all done. Relatively done. Obviously I can clean out the show because she'll probably sleep in poo, won't you, Luna?
Mm-hmm.